balo.
Thank you, Chief Commander. To our esteemed Regional Director, Chief Superintendent Alma G. Abakahima Maayong Butet. To our hyperactive Assistant Regional Director for Administration, Senior Superintendent Franklin Ratonoshio Masmaayong Butet. And to our Assistant Regional Director for Operations, Senior Superintendent Richie Bantiser Maayong Butet. To our always blooming Regional Chief of Staff, Senior Superintendent Alan A. Cabotier Maayong Butet. To all the division chiefs. And okay, happy birthday! Later, pagkatahan si RCS ha. Abusog po sa dati. To the division chiefs, to my co-commissioned officers, to the NUPs, to the NCOs, and all in attendance, may buta na lang muna. Recently, there is a pending bill. When you say pending bill, it's pending with the House of Representatives. This is House Bill 9932. And House Bill 9931. RA 9932 is entitled as the Single Well-Being Leave Act. This bill aims to provide a privilege to single employee and that they are allowed to go on leave every February 15 of the year. The rationale behind, according to the author, is that while February 14 is a romantic day for those who have, you know, partners in life, couples, so on and so forth, Valentine's Day creates immoral and social pressure among those who don't have. While on February 14, people are busy buying flowers, bouquets, so on and so forth, going to dates, what about the single employees who don't have partners? That is why the bill aimed to give them a non-deductible one-day leave on February 15. Now let's go to House Bill 9931. The House Bill 9931 is entitled Heartbreak Well-Being Leave. If you are 25 years old, an employee is 25 years old, is given a one-day non-deductible leave. For those aging 25 up to 35, you are given 2 days non-deductible leave. For 35 years up, you're given 3 days non-deductible leave. What's the rationale of the law? Employees who suffer heartbreaks and breakups, painful agony, affects the mental and the well-being of the employee. Diba? So, hindi na siya effective, diba? Sige na lang hukmo, sige na lang hila. So, Congressman's wife finds it imperative to have this particular deal. The requirement is that you must have to sign or you have to submit an affidavit of confession that you have suffered breakup or heartbreak within a period of 30 days prior to the specific date that you wanted to avail the leave. No? If this will pass into law, for sure, maraming mag-a-apply dito. Di ba? Well, this is an amiable law, or I mean bill. Others call it as a weird law. No, medyo bago sa paningin and medyo bago sa pandinig. But actually, there are so many weird laws that is in effect in the, I mean, throughout the world. For example, in Samoa, it is illegal for new husbands to forget the birthday of your wife. And if your wife complains that you failed to remember your birthday, your husband can be imprisoned. See? Another weird law is that in Turin, Italy, you are required to walk your dog at least 3 times a day. And in Milan, Italy, it is illegal for you to let your chicken cross the highway or the busy street. Pero sa Philippines, wala naman ang deminsan. Because in Milan, Italy, they consider chicken as a sacred delicacy. That is why they don't allow chicken to cross the road. If you caught me here, you will be put in prison. Now, in Philippines also, we have certain weird law. Because in Philippines, if you kill someone, you cannot at all be in prison. This is under Article 147 of the Revised Penal Code. If you kill your spouse under scandalous circumstances or having an actual sexual act with somebody, you can in your spouse, but you cannot be in prison. Because I discovered under that exempting circumstance. No? Medyo weird siya. Walang may uniform, medyo weird ang Filipino. But anyway, there are also laws that are appealed by millions to us to be law. One of which is Republic Act 1948. Are you familiar with Republic Act 1948? It's very old law. It's a decades old law, no? Or the clerical error law. Gone are those days na magka-problema mo sa spelling sa inyong names over the birth certificate, your gender, first name, so on and so forth. Before, you'll have to go to a lawyer, petition the court, and you'll have to pay a lot. This time, you'll just go to the local civil registrar, file a petition there, pay 650 pesos, wait for the publication, but it's there. So, for those who are planning to change their names, you can do so. Remember, for married women, under the provisions with surnames in the civil code, you are not, it's not mandatory for you to use the surname of your husband. If you wanted to retain your maiden surname, that's just fine. No?